webcasting for a worldwide audience.
Bye. poor.
That's really poor. Where's your valve?
I don't know. It fell out, didn't it?
Yeah.
Welcome to Sonic's Pick a Mix on Radio Lewis, where the music matters.
Well, that was a bit of a disappointing entrance, wasn't it? But, you know.
Wow.
you really do need to take that horn apart.
I need to try and get...
Because it's got a chink to it now.
I was going to get a bike until I saw yesterday, but we'll talk about that later.
Oh. Yes. Yeah. What? Cycle lanes proposals.
Don't start already.
I've had you in my ear all the way up here. So, yeah. Just settle in. Settle down. You've already eaten one of your snacks. So that's that.
I had a Rice Krispie Square.
Rice Krispie Square. 10 pence
from Fred Shop. Out of date. Lovely.
Yeah, and you've given me one with a great flourish. Thank you very much.
They're nice. Got plenty
when
of
do they go out of date?
Today.
Oh, well, it'll be all right.
Got plenty of loo roll at home, though, yeah?
Yeah. I have now. Although I'm thinking about starting to stock up.
I would
for
do.
The second wave.
Got your masks ready?
Yeah, get your mask ready. Yep. Yeah. On your marks, get set, go.
Run around, might read again.
A beautiful Sunday morning. We've just walked up the town. You've said hello to nearly everybody.
Well, you can't help being a man about town.
I know. What is it with you?
I don't know.
Now you've taken over the newspaper industry.
Oh, I've got all the...
You've got them all over.
Morningside.
The early brigade. Of up and out and get your paper.
Yeah, you wait till Christmas for the tips.
Oh, yeah. We've never had Christmas tips before.
I'll have to get security
going. You won't get tips, will you?
I will if I take it off the paper, boys.
Yeah, you could fashion something, you know, a nice little tip box and chain it to the counter. Yeah.
My size sounds charity box.
Ah. We've just stood by the big red post box on the corner of, well, the top of School Hill.
Yep.
And ceremoniously saluted as you've posted the keys back.
Posted the keys back on the envelope inside. Security minded, I put the address of the shop and the postcode. So if anybody opens them up, they've got themselves a shop.
Well, good luck to them. That's all I can
good
say.
Luck.
He's gone. He's
yep.
gone. Gone. Gone.
Yep. I can say it all now. It's rotten as a pear, that place.
Yeah. Did you shut the door very carefully? You didn't slam it. It'd be like Frank Spencer when he shuts his door and his house falls down.
That fascia above it. Why have you never painted your name on it? I was told, first thing, don't ever touch that.
Don't touch it.
How the hell it's still standing is beyond
me. Well, you know, it's a bit like most
it's
of the properties.
It's like Frank Spencer's house, isn't it?
It is. But yeah, like most of that. The properties in Lewis.
Yeah.
Held together with bits of string and a wing and a prayer and lots of money.
Yes.
You know, but yeah, close it very quietly and creep off.
And run off.
Don't. If it falls down now.
Be hilarious. Not mine. I ain't got a key.
No.
It's not insured.
What's going to go in there?
It's going to go.
John Lewis.
It's going to be for sale. John Lewis?
John Lewis.
Well, that
they're scaling
now.
Yeah, but they're scaling it all down, aren't they?
Yeah.
There could be John Lewis in there now. The way things are going, there could be anything in there.
Next.
Lord only knows.
Could be in there.
Could be.
Boots,
the chemist.
Yeah.
Could be a department store.
Could be.
Couldn't it? It could be a shopping centre.
Cloth kits.
They
could come back with their orange jumbo cord.
Do you know what? That'd do well, cloth kits, I reckon.
Ippy it clothes. Would.
Yeah. I used to love cloth kits.
Yeah. I'm an old Ippy.
But, you know, it's just wait and see. But it does feel very strange because your legs, you're like homing pigeon. Your legs just go to Station Street,
don't they? Yeah, they just go. Luckily, they only work around the corner, so it's not.
I wonder how many times you're just going to walk and stand there
and just
see.
Well, I started getting a free coffee from the Turks.
I don't live here no more, no.
I started getting free coffee from the Turks opposite.
Yeah.
So I've got to go down there to get me free coffee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you're still a signed
Morningside,
up member.
Come and get your free coffee, he says.
A part of your heart has been left in Station Street.
I've left a few other bits in there as well, like a ladder.
Have you?
I thought, what should I do with that ladder? And I'll leave it. It's got a dodgy rung on it, that'll be all right.
Did you leave it in the shop?
Yeah, of course I did.
Well, you could say it came with the shop.
I left it in the corner for the morning.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh, it'd be all right.
Yeah, and I had a few bits and pieces that I'd forgotten to get rid of, so I stuffed them in the fuse box.
Oh, did you?
So, yes. And I open up.
It's like the good old days of the council swap, isn't it? Yeah,
yep.
Off we go. It's all on my handcart. There we are.
Box
the demise of Size Sound and the rebirth today.
Yes, I'm up here.
Yeah, today is your first real day of your new life.
Yeah, Radio Lewis, where the music matters.
Yeah.
Poor Radio Lewis.
Yeah, I know. It's like Tosses Yard in here, it is.
One of the ladies that comes up here went, she came in the shop the other day and she went, Hello, Si. She said, nice to see you put some more of your junk up the road.
Oh, well, junk.
Junk their heirlooms.
Dare you.
She was meaning my vintage bar.
Yeah, oh, yeah. The vintage bar is here now. Yes. Next to the font.
Yes,
marvellous.
It's still got a quarter bottle of rum in it
Has
now.
It really?
Yeah, it's been evaporating.
Don't tell me that. No, I'm feeling a little bit.
Should we have another tune?
Yeah. Excuse you. Bless you. Yeah. Oh, you're just telling me about a very good docu spoof. Yeah.
One on BBC iPod. If you've not seen it, do go and watch it. It's hilarious.
Yeah, it sounds really, really good. I saw it advertised and I thought it was a documentary, but you say it's like a spoof where the might have a go on that. But last night I watched the documentary of Live Aid. Did you watch it?
Oh, no, I didn't watch that.
35 years ago today.
Read the world.
Or was it the 13th? Yeah, or it might be tomorrow. Yeah, 35 years ago.
Good grief.
And, yeah, no, it's really good. It's a two-part. One of it's leading up to it, so I suppose when they made the single, and then the 12 weeks running up to it, and then the second part, which I watched last night, was the actual concert. Oh, my God. How they ever got that together is quite incredible, really. Yeah. It was a complete and utter fiasco, really. Yeah. But they've got, I think it was quite old, the documentary, because Brian May still had black hair.
Yeah, oh God, they made a documentary for
must have been 30 years.
For the 30 years.
So it looked like 5 years ago, because Billy Connolly's on there, and,
Bill.
Yeah, but he is much more with it, you know. Yeah. So it might be a repeat, but. Oh my goodness, when you watch it, it is incredible when you see the thousands of people who made their way to Wembley on that day.
Yeah.
How they just opened the gates and they all just shouted run. And they all just ran and found. I mean, they'd never let it happen. Well, they wouldn't let it happen now, would they?
No.
And all of the stars, and what a complete and utter cock up it was for some people. It was not their moment. They had Simon Le Bon on there. Because he sang a very, very bum note during it. Really, really bad bum note. And Tony Hadley.
Yep, don't mention
Tony Hadley. But, we're dropping his microphone things. No, it was quite entertaining.
Adam Ant got cut to one song.
He weren't on there. They must have cut him from the documentary as well.
He was cut to one song.
Lots of them were cut because they were all, running behind time.
And the ones that they wanted to carry on going were the best ones, was Queen.
It is a lot about Queen, because I didn't realise at the time when Queen went on that they were sort of not failing, but quite in a bit of stuff, and that was what absolutely launched them back into everything.
And you two overrun by about 20 minutes.
Oh, he did. He was on there. He was an absolute twit.
I like Boney.
Threw himself into the crowd and dragged somebody out. Yeah. They didn't know where he was and all that sort of thing.
I like Boney. He's funny.
No, honestly, it's one of those things that you... Well, obviously, if you can remember it, it is one of those things.
I remember seeing the bit where Phil Collins was going to fly across America and play in America.
There's a lot about that.
I was hoping at the time that the plane
would crash.
Don't. But he didn't. No,
he went by Concorde. Which you think, well,
obviously, caught fire.
Don't. and the story behind that is very, very interesting as well.
They just wanted to get rid of him.
Yeah, they hoped to, but he did turn up, didn't he?
He turned up to
be with Led Zeppelin.
Yeah.
And they absolutely bombed Led Zeppelin. They were terrible. And then it was all about how they actually blamed Phil Collins for being a terrible drummer, for the fact that they really, really bombed.
I agree entirely.
Your favourite. A really good couple of hours, but it was very nostalgic. And then, of course, they showed the bit where everybody was really, really up, and then they stopped and they showed that film.
Showed that film.
Who?
David.
It was Lord David. Lord David was on there, and he cut his set to show Drive.
I've got this film to show you now.
And, and they show it on the documentary, and true to form, I sat there crumbling blinking eyes out.
I do, because I thought he could have done Gene Genie in that spot.
Shame on you. Shame on you. And I do think 35 years on, the world's in such a better place, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
There you are. Yeah.
Got your
mask. And, funny old times, but very, very entertaining.
Let me uplift you, shall I?
Yeah, go on then.
Yeah. We'll be right back.
be another bicentennial before I hear the truth from your mouth. You better hear me out.
Crown of Coconuts with Cota Mundi. Mino Papai.
Mundi. Oh, and that's one of our favourites.
Yeah, you've got to go and listen to the lyrics of that one.
Yes, I must admit, there were one or two. How many times must I have listened to that song? And then you pointed out some of the lyrics in the middle of it are quite fruity, aren't they? I think you just sort of get taken over with the beat and you can say anything, really, can't you?
Yeah, and they do.
Quite really. Quite really. That's good. Oh, dear, you've been feeling about your own...
Bicycles.
Pardon? Oh, don't start on it. So, down the town yesterday...
There was a parade of people on bikes.
I did hear them.
Yep.
I had a wonderful day yesterday because Shell came down from West Norwood. First time since February. She braved the train... Wore her mask and then told me all the tales of all the people that were sitting on the train without their masks on. Great big gangs of Australians and Chinese all travelling about all over the place. They get on the train with their masks on.
Yep.
When they're standing in the platform, you're standing on the platform in the air, everybody's got their masks on, standing there, oh yes, very good. Get on the train, they'll take their masks off. So she's sitting in the carriage. Only person with her mask on, surrounded by people laughing and joking, la la la, bearing in mind you can't open the window or anything on train anymore.
Right.
Nobody enforces it. And then, when it's time to get off, out in the air, back on with the masks.
Back on with the masks.
So, a farce. Yeah. So we went to town and we heard lots of shouting, but I didn't know what it was.
It was a load of people on bicycles that are, you know, bicycles clean, for good for the environment and that. There was about a 2 mile tailback of cars behind them.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And it turns out, I found out later on what they are protesting for.
Mm.
Their proposal is that they stop all... There's no parking on School Hill.
Right.
And that space that they would save, build a cycle path so they can go down School Hill. They go down School Hill without a cycle path, so why do they need a cycle path?
When they go down School Hill, then what do they do when they get to the bottom?
I don't know. I hope they've got brakes, because it's only one way.
That's what I mean. Yeah, but then, no, then what are they going to do? Go straight path into the traffic?
Yeah. Cyclists can do what they like.
Well.
Idiots, that's what I say.
Do you like your bikey? Do you think it's not going to happen, is it?
Is it
backed by the council?
One of the councillors, Ruth O'Keefe.
Oh, Keith O'Roof.
Keith O'Roof, who we know very well from our Rocket Days.
We do know Keith O'Roof from our old Rocket Days.
She loved us. She used to cry when she
did, actually. Yeah, we used to come. We used to follow up after her, didn't we? Follow up the rear.
Yeah, after them. Very serious show.
And although very welcoming when we turned up, weren't they?
Yeah, we had all their knob-knobs.
Yeah, we did. She had good biscuits.
You had her whiskey glass.
Shut up. But they had good biscuits, those councillors, as I recall.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very good.
We used to swap our lemon puffs for our Robnobs.
And them lemon puffs, we put them from the boots out, didn't we? And they were very soft.
Oh, yeah, lemon puffs from the boots out.
They were very tangy.
Memories. So do you think this is going to come to fruition?
Oh, I hope not, because I think it's ridiculous.
I don't understand it. Why it's going to take me a while to process.
Yeah, process it while we play Favourite Shirt. Favourite Shirt.
Oh, very, very good. Very much in the 80s. And, you know, at the time I was watching the documentaries last night.
Oh, yeah.
Straight afterwards, it was I Love the 80s, hosted by Grace Jones.
Oh, dear. Saved her.
Oh, what a nutcase she is.
Yeah.
Talking about Haircut 100, you've been barbers, didn't you?
Well, of course I have, yes.
What was your experience at the barbers like?
That was interesting.
Did you have to wear a mask?
No, I didn't have to.
Right,
I said, do you want me to wear a mask? He said, no, you're okay. He said, because he's got full gear on.
I'll trim your beard.
No, can't trim beards.
Oh, your beard looks good, though. Yeah. You've had a go at it yourself.
I bought a pair of clippers myself.
Very nice, very nice.
Yes.
So, you don't have to wear a mask.
No, he wore one of them big visors, which kept steaming up, which I thought was hilarious.
Oh, bless him.
Well, the most concerning thing is that I can't get out of a scotch.
They won't let you have a drink
in there now. You can't offer you a scotch, so I took me home.
Good, yeah. Because that was always a bit of a draw to that barber's, was that you could have a wee nip while you're having a trim.
Yeah.
So he had his big visor on. Did he have a mask on underneath?
No.
Right, because I think that's optional, apparently, for hairdressers.
He wouldn't be able to. He would have steamed up entirely. No. Fred had his done on Friday, a very nice haircut. I was hoping he was going to go for a bobble perm, but he didn't.
No, he normally does.
Yeah,
he's gone for a change then.
Fred had a perm, he wouldn't.
No. Mullet?
No, well, nearly.
He could quite easily turn his hair into a mullet.
Yeah, easy.
So, did you have to? Because I know Nana went to the hairdressers, the one on Station Street, actually. She turned up for her appointment.
She had her chin done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was about time her jib, she was tripping over it.
Yeah.
And she went for her appointment and obviously had her time, but was told to go away again because... You can't go in there and wait, if they're 10 minutes over.
You've got to be on time.
So she had to walk up and down, and then she said, is thy shop shut? And she was about to come in and buy Val Dunica now.
Oh, was she?
Yeah, she was. Ah. So she had to plough up and down Station Street waiting for her time slot. So that's another thing, is that, was there nobody in there?
No, he was, your appointment's now 45 minutes.
Right.
And then they
they give it all a wipe
then
down.
They give 15 minutes clearing up. And that. Because the appointment was for 3:10 and I got there at 3 o'clock. Because it's rude to be late.
It is rude.
And I sat and waited outside.
And little... this is the barber's where?
Market Street.
Give him a plug.
Market Street.
Yeah.
Gentleman's hair.
Yes. Upstairs, downstairs.
Upstairs, downstairs.
Do they do downstairs?
I don't know. Well, not at the moment because they don't do beards.
No. Well, enough said then, really. Oh, it's nice to know that people are getting, back into the groove, and it must be really hard work, mustn't it, with all that gear on.
I was lucky I had haircuts all the way through lockdown.
Well, you did, but there you are. I, on the other hand, am very much looking forward to going and having my wig done.
I thought it was Rusty Lady coming out the road when I saw you this morning.
Shut up. Yeah, it is. It's all different colours. Yeah, it is many shades, isn't it?
Yeah.
50 shades of grey. None of them my own. I'm really looking forward to going down to Strixhead to see another plug. We might as well advertise everybody. There's nowhere else in the town that can advertise local businesses.
No, it's true.
And I shall say to them, you can totally knock some money off my bill.
I'm going to start advertising Steph's Cafe over the road if I can get a bacon sandwich.
Steph's Cafe, where's that?
Just over the road, opposite the Brewer's Arms.
Is it?
Yeah.
What, where Dome was?
No, next to it, a little tiny place.
The little tiny place?
Yeah, it's been there for years.
Is it still, it's up and going again, is it?
Yeah, she's up and...
Oh, is that your new place?
Well, it will be if she gets the pan out early enough.
Yeah. get the old bacon out early enough. Give her a plug. And of course, dear Just Williams and Just Williams Removals...
Removing.
Oh, caramba. I can't believe it. I don't know what's going on. Everybody's moving, I think. Everybody must be moving in the town.
It's moving out
bonkers.
Before the crony
Absolutely
comes.
Absolutely bonkers. He's got a bad shoulder this morning.
Oh,
shifted the piano yesterday.
Ooh, what is that?
Yeah, him and another bloke, but got it up a couple of flights of stairs and then couldn't get around the corner, so that's take it all apart. I said, what do you mean you took it all apart? He's taken the keys off, the back off, everything, threw it around the corner, with the customer's consent, and then they were going to...
The family bit's over.
Well, I don't know if remantle's a word. We've discussed this before. Do you dismantle? Do you remantle? Or you just mantle it?
Assemble.
And then put it back together again. The amount of pianos that people are having shifted.
I wouldn't mind a piano up here, if I could get one in there.
You haven't got room for a cigarette paper, let alone a piano.
It's a bit
cosy.
You just
about get your kazoo in.
You wait till the Christmas tree goes up. In 140 days.
Oh, it's a big one in Cumberland.
It's only 160 days, 66 days to Christmas.
Oh, don't. I'm just counting for...
130 days' time. Christmas tree will be up.
130 days.
Start dusting down your tinsel.
Yeah, well, I'm not that I ever count, and I've said this before, but I've turned into a counter. 8 more days at school. 8 more days of school. My mind is leaving the building already and turning our attention to when they're all going to come back in September. But by jingo, one more week of children.
And then run into Christmas.
And then woohoo! Yeah, let's have it.
Let's have it. Yeah. Shall we have a tune?
Yeah, go on.
To go, nameless towns with faceless.
cut him off.
Yeah, because it goes into the next track, which is it's a good album. That was Visage with Damn Don't Cry from the Anvil album.
Poor old Stephen Strange.
Yeah, weird to think he's dead. Yeah.
We're just saying that he's been gone a while, hasn't he?
Yeah,
strange that, isn't it?
Died of heart attack in Egypt.
Did he?
Yeah.
Don't attack in Egypt.
Yeah, it was in Egypt. He got revived by a camel or something, I don't know.
Oh.
But yeah.
Oh, well, there you are.
There you go.
Yeah, sorry. I didn't know that.
We're just
checking the world around us.
Yeah.
There seems to be only one headline on the news feed this morning.
Slush Puppy.
Which is about cyber.
By Cyberforce.
Don't know what that's all about,
no,
do you?
What's wrong with their drinks? I don't know.
Something going on. But we have been, we've just been talking about coronavirus hotspots.
Yeah.
And how lead news today seems to be that there's about 20 councils that are, areas of concern for a leap above going over one. And that the army's all poised and all that malarkey. Who knows what's going on? And that led me to, I don't know if I told you this, when I left here last week, and I went for a walk down the Grange, didn't I?
Oh, yes, yeah.
There's a gentleman sitting on a bench with another lady, and my sister I was with, she said, look over there, look who it is.
And it was
Chris Whitty.
Yeah.
Chris Whitty of, the Daily Bulletin. And she's, I think that's Chris Whitty. Which he's got a strange looking appearance at times, and he looks even stranger when you see him in the flesh. Anyway, I said, go up and ask him. She wouldn't. And I had a small child with me, and I like to use a small child as a guide for me charging up. So we walked casually past the bench, and I said, Mr. Whitty? And he said, yes. And I had a small child, and we said, we'd come out to say thank you for keeping us safe. And he said, well, thank you very much. And a small child with me, Albie, said to him, and I never doubted you for a moment. I'm like, shut up. And with that, Chris Whitty fell about laughing. He said, well, thank you very much. And I said, have a lovely Sunday. He said, we will, thank you. And we trundled off. So fancy that. Chris
stars
Whitty.
Everywhere.
I know, stars everywhere.
I see Kirsty Allsop in home base.
Did you?
Brian Woodchip.
Not
and
again.
Magnolia.
Yeah. Old Kirsty. Well, they do get around the town, don't they?
Yeah.
she's
Sting. I used to see him in Aldi.
Oh, yeah, you used to see him in Aldi.
Buying that coffee with Playboy.
But you know what? I've not been in Aldi since before lockdown.
Well Steve still gets in there.
Yeah. Oh, does he?
Yeah.
Oh, he is a pest, though, isn't he?
He says, don't stand so close to me.
Yeah, I know. Well, he's very good for social distancing,
he is. Yeah.
But they get around town. But that is true about Chris Whitty.
So it was mine. What are you talking about?
Yeah, I'm sure it is. And apparently he lives close by. He must be having a rest day and is fed up with tweets coming up to him saying, Mr. Whitty.
Yes.
Said, yes.
Mr. Whitty, you're a
twit. It might not have been him. It might have been somebody who looked like him.
Yes.
So there you are. You never know what's coming up around here, do you?
No, you never know.
No, there you go. Yuck.
We're on the record.
Yeah, go on.
Your goodbyes, but things don't always go the way that
Very, very good.
Hungry Like the Wolf.
Hungry Like the Wolf.
Darren.
Ah, very, very good. We're just talking about documentaries. Yes. Some good ones, music ones at the moment. So what was the one that you've just watched?
We watched Joy Division one last night.
Right.
I think it's just called Joy Division. It's made by the members of that right. were around Joy Division, yeah.
Yeah. Are they still all with us then?
Well, it's New Order.
Ah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they
are.
Don't talk to one another now.
Oh, they don't. All right. Okay.
I met Hookie. Me and Dave Archery met Hookie and Toby.
Oh, did they come? He didn't come and shop, did he?
No, we went to a gig and we...
Oh, I remember that. Oh, yeah. I bet he remembers it as well.
I bet he does. Dave says, I'm afraid I'm going upstairs.
I'm afraid I'm going upstairs. I often turn to Amazon Prime at the moment. They've got some good gear
on there.
I've just finished watching, and I watched it all in one week, mind you, it might be Netflix. Anyway, Unorthodox. Which is about the Orthodox Jewish lady who tries to escape and everything.
Yeah.
Very, very good.
Very good. We're watching
Miss
America.
Very good. Yeah, I've got that recorded. That's, is it good?
It's very good, yeah.
And is it the true...
Yeah, it's all true.
Yeah. All quite fancy.
It's got Tracy Ullman in it, but don't let that put you off.
Oh, yeah.
Well, so she plays a good part. I mean,
Does she play an American?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I know, I've got that recorded, but I do like to sort of get a stack up.
Yeah.
I do. I'm not very good. It's terrible, silent times.
We started watching Waking Dead again, very first one.
Oh, really? They won't wake them.
No,
they're still there.
And I don't see a whole episode.
No. So it's good then. It puts you to sleep, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So it's that riveting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right from the beginning?
Yeah.
What with Trevor Eve?
Trevor Eve, Shoestring.
Oh, yeah. Shoestring.
Yeah.
Yes, but some of that early stuff, it's too early for me.
Like it.
It's too early. You just think, oh,
I want them to bring the Chinese detective back. Well, they don't seem to want
him. Oh, remember him?
Yeah,
the Chinese detective.
And Nighthawk.
Nighthawk.
Whispering Jack, whatever.
Goodness.
His name was.
Whispering
in a lighthouse,
Jack.
He did.
Yeah, pardon?
He lived in a lighthouse.
Did he?
Yeah.
Who?
Nighthawk.
Oh, he did, didn't he?
Yeah.
Nighthawk. Oh, no.
What was that, Day of the Triffids?
Oh, I don't know. But you're watching too much telly. It's too much.
Misty for me.
Yeah. Mind you, if you just put it on to make yourself go to sleep, it's all right, isn't it? Off like a treat. Yeah. You're still keeping downstairs, aren't you?
Oh, yes.
Ah, yes. Household, it's like 40 towels in your house, isn't it?
Anybody wants to adopt
children? Bodies everywhere.
Do get in touch with me.
Yeah, I know.
Pop your name on a postcard.
You did offer your child up for adoption to that lady you met up the town, didn't you?
Yeah, she was most surprised, wasn't she?
Yeah, she was. She was saying how much she loved your son.
I think we can have him.
Yeah, she said, have him. Go on, have him. It frightened her right off, didn't it? He said, he's out for adoption. You can have him for nothing. And then she just laughed and walked away. And you
actually,
you
so
meant
funny.
It, though, didn't you?
I meant it, yeah. I had the papers ready in my bag.
Got them already all the time.
Just
poised, yeah. So, yeah, it's some viewing to be had, but I expect today our Sunday afternoon will be full of cricket, because it's cricket versus...
Oh.
It's England versus the West Indies.
Is it?
Yeah, but I like a bit of cricket.
Do you?
Yeah, I know, but it's great for having a kip.
Oh,
yeah. I've got a couple of old newspapers and a magazine and all that sort of thing. I'm nearly on the home straight with finishing reports. Well, finished my own, but I'm reading it, proofreading, which is very, very difficult to proofread. I find that very difficult.
I'm going to watch Match of the Day again.
What, Match of the Day again? What, are you going to watch Brighton get beat?
Yeah, Brighton get beat and what, West Ham 1-4-0. But I've got it on repeat. I'm going to just keep watching it because it's perfect. It makes me happy.
See, an afternoon of sport.
Yeah. I might even film Brighton getting beat and send it to Keith just to upset him.
Are they in danger now?
Still, a little bit. A little bit, not too much.
Brighton, game. I mean.
Yeah, they could be.
Right.
It could be if the others started winning, but no, they'll survive another season.
Oh, do you think they will?
Yeah.
What, even though they lost 5-0?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Okay, I don't get it. Yeah. And when is the season over?
Another two games.
Another two games
and
it's over.
And then it's over till the 1st of August.
Right.
Well, they normally finish in March.
Do they?
They finish at the end of March, and it was about 6 games to go.
Right.
And then lockdown, so they've had to play the 6 games.
So they're going to just keep rolling.
They're going to have a month off and then go back, yeah.
When do you think that they will have, some sort of crowd there?
Oh, I don't know.
Because you'd think that they'd be able to mark out every other set. Mind you, it's everybody bundling to get there, isn't it?
It's the bundling to get there. It's alcohol.
Yeah.
It's people being told what to do with alcohol. Doesn't work.
No, it doesn't. And, and it is very odd watching the cricket. They have that sort of, you know, that background noise on, but obviously they don't have the cheering and everything, like people talking, that sort of thing. And it's just weird, though, when they just scan around and there's nobody there.
It's weird, isn't it?
It is very, very, very odd, strange. Isn't it? Yeah.
And why they've showed 2 weeks of Wimbledon past is beyond me.
Oh, well, I don't know. I've missed all of that. It's to make strawberry sales go up, I expect.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sue Barker's been there all week eating strawberries.
Is she?
All on her own. She's got to eat a lot.
She's a glutton, Great, that woman. She'd be right on the trot, she will. Yeah. Oh, go on.
We'll be right back.
caught you was there, Japan, with the art of pies.
I do like
from
a bit
1981.
I really do. You don't see him much about.
No, he's an artiste in America.
Oh, one of those. Yes. An artiste. Get me. Yes.
That's it. My little chickpea.
We've overrun.
We're going to go overrun because I'm playing the last one.
Oh, yeah. Let's have a signing off treat.
Yep.
Listen, stay out of trouble.
Who?
You.
Oh.
Yeah, don't start picking fights. and have a good week.
And you.
Yeah, and we'll see you, this time next week.
Next week. Thank you very much for listening to our next Pickwick on Radio Lewis, where the music matters.
Yes.
All in one.
That's very good. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. See you. Oh, by the way.
What?
It's Thompson Twins.
Oh.
Just wanna